Hey, everybody on the Pro Forum. So this question was just asked in the thread. So, hey, I'll make a movie about it. Getting rid of the little fine hairs out on the outside of an image. I have both a light and a dark image. So if it's a lighter image, what I'll do is I'll take my paintbrush in normal mode at a reduced opacity. I don't know, somewhere in the 60s, I guess. And I'll get kind of a big soft-edged brush. Whoops. Big soft edge brush, and I'll take a little shortcut is to hold your Alt key while in the brush mode and click, and you take a sample of that color right next to where you was wanting to paint. And so then I'll just brush it like that, because I don't want to totally get rid of those hairs as much as I want to just sort of diminish the fact that they're sticking out so much. And so just by doing it like that, that is a really fast way of making it not so brutally obvious on a lighter background. Now, I'm going to undo that. Another way, there's so many ways to do things in Photoshop. Another way would be use your clone tool, again with reduced opacity. Clone out here and then just sort of clone in right in there. It's kind of the same thing. You're just cloning in the colors. And that's how I do it on a lighter background. So let me get rid of this. Don't save. Okay, on a darker background, it becomes a lot more tricky. Same principle applies, but it sometimes doesn't match so good. So I'll take my paintbrush, click, and then I'll just rub. Because I'm really, at this point, I just want to get it kind of darkened. So it's kind of like a multi-step process. So I get it all nice and darkened. Then I'll take my burn tool, and I'll put it in highlight mode. Make sure that the protection up here is turned off. And I'll burn down those highlights. So again, I'm not necessarily wanting to totally get rid of the hairs as much as I want to darken it and not make it so, you know, brutally obvious. All right, so now that I've darkened it like that, then I'll probably do a little bit of clone at a low opacity. Like that's in the 30s and 40s. I'll do a little bit of right in there. And then the ones that stick way out, what I'll do is I will healing brush the ones that stick way out so it ain't quite so sticky outy. So there we go. How about like that? Okay, then what I always like to do, this is just a raw image. I want to make sure that this looks good, that it blends nicely with what's going on around it. So in that case, I'm going to have to flip this to mid-tones, bring the exposure up a little bit, and I'm going to have to blend this, that darkened area that I did, but to blend that in around the outside of it. So here we go, all the way before, let me slide that over, before, after. And I'm sure you can tell that now if they watched me do this, it would be a problem, because then they would know just where to look. But if someone doesn't watch you do this, then what happens is it becomes less critical to their eye because they're hanging out in this area in the close-up of the face area. They're not looking out here on the edge of the hair. But if they see it like this, they're going to jump on that hair and they're not going to like it. Hopefully that helps you. Talk to y'all tomorrow. Bye.